Today we continue to have a great presentation in the sense of what we're talking about is the here and now, where we talk about the future of agriculture, we also celebrate our past. And today we get to hear from our governor, but we also get a luncheon that's gathered for our ag ambassador as well. But our next speaker has been staying true to the notion of being South Dakota's number one salesman. As I've had the chance to work with him and spend time with him either in China or across South Dakota, agriculture has continued to be a priority. And we've seen that in the value-added processing of adding Bell Brands, joining the state of South Dakota. We've seen that in the continuation of supporting us, not in just telling them that we're going to promote agriculture or dairy, but we're also following through on our commitments. And so, folks, it is a tremendous privilege as we celebrate agriculture today. We recognize that we have leadership of our state that's promoting and lifting up the renewable fuel standard. We have someone who is getting behind and saying we need to make sure we have the right infrastructure in our state, rail structure, with the Surface Transportation Board hearing. He's been relevant, and the path of relevance is a journey, and our governor's been leading the charge. So please help me in welcoming the gentleman of South Dakota, our governor, Dennis Daugaard.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon and welcome to Deadwood. It's good to be here. It was nice to see such a green landscape on the trip up here to Deadwood, and that's the landscape that we're pretty much seeing all across South Dakota. There's a few pockets that are a little bit dry. There's a few pockets that are very, very wet, but most of South Dakota is just spectacular and beautiful. After 2 years in Sioux Falls and then a couple years in Pierre, it's good to bring the Ag Summit. This is our fifth annual Ag Summit. Good to bring it West River. And I understand from talking with Secretary Lynch that you had some good opportunities to see what South Dakota Ag does out here, from mountain pine beetle battles to wildfire battles to promoting one of our new fledgling industry, the wine industry. And I understand Secretary Lynch was especially good at promoting that aspect. No, I don't know that. I do want to start, though, by thanking you, the farmers and ranchers and members of the agribusiness community, for coming together and supporting this summit. Your work's vital to the future development of our agriculture industry in South Dakota, and I appreciate that you've taken the time to be here. I also want to just recognize and express appreciation to our sponsors, AgriPure, Bayer Crop Science, Dakota Bank, Farm Credit Services of America, First Dakota National Bank, Monsanto, Sanford Health, South Dakota Ethanol Producers, and the Valley Queen Cheese, and Zoetis. Let's give them all a round of applause, if I may. You know, I couldn't help, having grown up on a dairy farm myself, I couldn't help but notice a couple of our sponsors are in the dairy industry, AgriPure and Valley Queen, both major cheese producers, and we're grateful for their sponsorship. And I do have an interest in dairy. Dean Dunn was kind enough to give me and some of my team a tour of the dairy facilities at SDSU. And I know this has happened to you, but it happened to me that day. I was in one of the barns, and there were some of the cattle didn't notice that I was there, and a couple cows were talking to each other. And, you know, they had the necklace. One was Daisy. Apparently it said right on there, Daisy. The other one was Dolly, and Daisy leaned over to Dolly and she said, "You know, I was artificially inseminated this morning." And Dolly said, "I don't believe it." And Daisy said, "It's true, no bull." Okay, that didn't really happen. You thought I was being a little inappropriate there, didn't you? Just for a second, just a little bit. Thank you very much for making this year's Ag Summit a success, and we're grateful for all that you do for Ag. This year, we celebrate South Dakota's 125th birthday. It was 125 years ago this year that the President of the United States signed the document that split the Dakota Territory into North Dakota and South Dakota. Our state is well known as an ag state, and we always have been. And we're proud of that. I'm proud of that. From our state's infancy, agriculture has been the bedrock of our economy, and it's also a touchstone of our values. The willingness to start before dawn and quit long after the sun's gone down. The dedication to see a job through, no matter how difficult the task. The courage to stand up for what's right, even when it's unpopular. And the perseverance to tough it out when times are tough and be able to savor the joy of the good times. These are the values of agriculture, and they're also South Dakota's values as a consequence. They radiate through men and women who call South Dakota home. For families who work the land, agriculture truly is more than a job. It's more than something one does to earn money. Agriculture is a passion and a lifestyle, and it's defined our entire state. Now, engaging in agriculture has always involved risk. In the 1800s, the cowhands who trailed cattle to railheads like Belle Fouche, Smithwick, and Buffalo Gap navigated blizzards, fought rustlers, got trampled by stampeding cattle, and broke bones while breaking horses. The homesteaders who followed them fought drought, insect plagues, crop failures, and low prices. Mother Nature is not always kind. Our farmers and ranchers know that more acutely than most. Of course, the 2012 drought impacted every corner of South Dakota. And then last year, many producers lost calves in a spring ice storm. Last October, ranchers lost tens of thousands of cattle in Winter Storm Atlas. And recently, just very recently, floods and tornadoes have devastated fields and farms and homes. Yet, South Dakotans have and will continue to persevere. Even as Winter Storm Atlas brought devastation, it also reminded us of the kindness of our neighbors. Thousands of people stepped forward to lend a helping hand, whether fixing fence, rounding up cattle, sharing a warm meal, or simply providing a shoulder to lean on, South Dakotans answered the call. Nothing symbolizes the strength of our ag community as well as the Rancher Relief Fund. Organized in a joint effort of the Cattlemen's Association, the stock growers, and the sheep growers, it provided hope and assistance. More than $5 million raised through that effort demonstrates what we can accomplish working together. And I know some of the leaders of that effort are here. I want to recognize Sylvia Christian, Jody Hickman Anderson, and Max Matthews, and also Rick Valerie, who helped administer the fund. I know some of them are here. Would you stand and let us thank you? Isn't Sylvia here? And Jody was here. Okay, they found it. Oh, there you are. Apparently, Jody was the only one who didn't know who was speaking today. Thank you for what you did, Jody. Agriculture will always experience hardship and risk, but with the risk, of course, comes tremendous opportunities as well. For the fourth year in a row, South Dakota's gross domestic product has increased. During the last 5 years, our state's economy has grown by 25%, more than double the national rate of 14%. South Dakota's economic growth was led by our ag industry, which rebounded from a drought year in 2012 and then posted a 34% increase this year. Our incredible growth offers tremendous opportunities for economic development through a variety of value-added enterprises. Many new and existing South Dakota companies are taking advantage of these opportunities. If we can raise more pigs and sheep, feed more cattle, milk more cows, do all those things that we do in agriculture, the economic benefits will reverberate through our entire state. There will always be hardship and risk, but things are looking good in South Dakota. I'm optimistic about our future, and I hope you are too. Of course, one of our greatest opportunities exists through international trade. We heard a little bit about soybean trade just in the last session. Each year, South Dakota exports more than $3.6 billion worth of agricultural products. Most of our exports go to Canada and Mexico, but China has the largest potential for growth. With more than 1.3 billion people, including a growing middle class, looking for a higher quality diet, China is poised to increase its imports exponentially in the coming years. Now, the South Dakota Department of Agriculture and our Office of Economic Development have been working to refocus our international trade efforts. And this year, we hosted our third trade mission to China. And of course, our goal is to assist businesses in establishing and growing their exports by facilitating meetings with Chinese businesses to help our South Dakota companies grow those marketing opportunities. In fact, I met with Michael Skews at our first trade mission to China, and we were just laughing about that first encounter. The Department of Ag had a number of states gathered for a reception, and among a few elected leaders and secretaries of agriculture, I was invited to come to the platform and speak. And so I launched into this great speech about what wonderful agriculture was in South Dakota and how grateful we were to be in China and how pleased we were at the wonderful hospitality. I went on and on. And then after about 3 or 4 minutes, I suddenly realized I hadn't stopped to let the interpreter say what I was saying. So most of the audience was wondering, well, blah, 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 what's that guy saying up there? And of course, the interpreter was too polite to stop me, so I just went on and on and on like an idiot. But truly, it was great to meet Undersecretary Skews that day or that evening, and we spent some time at the food show as part of that trip as well, and I'm so grateful that he would come and share his international perspective with us here in South Dakota. And so, Mr. Skews, thank you so much for being with us and for sharing that knowledge that you have. Let's give him a round of applause. You know, that China trip has had some benefits, those China trips. Several businesses have signed new contracts or increased their current business with Chinese companies during these trips, which have only scratched the surface of China's untapped potential to purchase products made in South Dakota. One of our businesses that went along with us had a single contract with a Chinese company that arose unexpectedly. And they had been providing some ag products from South Dakota to that company, and they didn't know if they would lose that business once that single contract was up, and China might return to a non-United States supplier for the product they were getting. And I'm being a little bit oblique about this because I'm not sure how much they want public, but I am confident after that trip and after my conversation with our South Dakota business that the relationship is going to be ongoing, and that Chinese company is going to turn that one-time purchase into potentially multi-year purchases from this South Dakota company. So it is making a difference, and that company buys its product from South Dakota farmers. So it's important. We also took the opportunity on that trip to visit Inner Mongolia, which is one of the provinces of China. Just as the United States has 50 states, China has 30-some provinces, and one of those is called Inner Mongolia, not to be confused with the country Mongolia, but a different state of China called Inner Mongolia. We went up there and met with their governor and had a nice visit and dinner with that governor, and it looks like we're exploring the possibility of establishing a state-to-state kind of sister relationship with them. And that would hopefully encourage them to come here, just as we've been going to China, and develop more relationships. We also had a chance to meet with a large feed processor in China who serves the pork industry. And it was interesting to listen to their statistics. They were very open about some of their mortality rates, which are very significant in comparison to what we experience in a more advanced pork industry in South Dakota. And they are interested in learning from us. They're interested in buying from us. And I'm hopeful that we'll continue to find relationships, whether it be dairy, pork, or whatever it may be, soybeans, whatever it may be, to help encourage agriculture to find new markets in China. So, if you are thinking about international business and you believe that your product could have some connection, or your business associates could have some connection that would benefit from a Chinese visit or visit from someone from China, please be in touch with our Department of Agriculture, be in touch with our Economic Development Office, because we want to help you. Each year I look forward to the Ag Summit because it's a unique opportunity to share ideas, reflect on our past year, evaluate our strengths and weaknesses, and look to what's ahead. And when I look ahead, I do think the future of agriculture is bright. Recently, I became acquainted with the FFA creed. Now, I was in 4-H when I was a kid on the farm. I wasn't in FFA. But in reading the FFA creed, I was struck by the staying power of words written in 1928. I believe in the future of agriculture with a faith born not of words but of deeds, achievements won by the present and past generations of agriculturists, in the promise of better days through better ways, even as the better things we now enjoy have come to us from the struggles of former years. This optimistic first paragraph, which promises better days through better ways, is even more relevant today than it was in 1928. Thank you again for attending this year's summit. Thank you for what you do for our ag economy in South Dakota and your leadership. Have a safe drive home. Glad to be with you for this time. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now to the important part of this luncheon. The backbone of South Dakota agriculture is our fertile soil, but the true strength of this industry is our people. Farmers and ranchers take care of the land, but they also educate the public, influence decision makers, and provide visionary leadership. Each year, I'm proud to present the Governor's Ag Ambassador Award to an individual who goes above and beyond, a true industry leader, and I'm excited about this year's award. So let's take a look at this year's winner. Our state has long valued servant leadership, hard work, honesty, humility, and respect for others. This year's Governor's Ag Ambassador Award recipient embodies all of these qualities. This particular Ag Ambassador has made a positive contribution to agriculture by providing leadership, encouraging growth in the industry, advocating for modern agricultural practices, and influencing decision makers to develop sound policies for agriculture. I am pleased to announce the 2014 Governor's Ag Ambassador, Brad Greenway.
Brad Greenway graduated from the Agriculture Management Program at Mitchell Technical Institute in 1984. He and his wife, Peggy, have a diversified farm west of Mitchell. They are part owners in Blue Stem Family Farms, which is the source of piglets for the Greenways' wean-to-finish swine operation. They have two children and one grandchild.
So one of the great things that we enjoy when we recognize an ag ambassador is also that of the support network behind them. And with Brad's leadership, but frankly with Peggy's support on the home front, it allows him to have that ability to go out and serve not only the state, but the ag industry as a whole across the country.
Brad has been involved with agriculture at many levels, locally, nationally, and internationally.
Brad's been very instrumental in the Adopt a Retailer program at the national level. This program is geared to address issues that retailers, particularly grocery stores, may have regarding production practices and how the pork that they supply through their food chain is produced. And Brad's retailer that he's working with is Costco Foods, a major retailer in the U.S. And Costco relies on Brad as their point man should they have any issues from their consumers or any of their customers regarding how their pork is being produced and what production practices are being utilized.
Brad's willingness to travel internationally to promote the pork industry literally has added thousands of dollars into most pork producers' pockets because of that proactive stance that he's taken.
Brad currently serves on the South Dakota Pork Producers Executive Board as the National Pork Board representative.
One of the things that I think differentiates him as a leader is his willingness to work with people of all stations at all times. It's just fun to watch him interact with students because his energy and his passion pull them into the discussion, encourage them to be involved. And again, it's just fun to watch because he just connects with young people in a very, very important way.
He's been very instrumental in addressing student bodies as well as civic organizations and government organizations and indicating to them and in showing them how a modern farm operation looks and demystify some of the myths that they may have about those operations.
Brad, you've done so much. I congratulate you on your passion for and commitment to our ag industry. You and your family truly represent the family farm unit here in South Dakota. I can't think of anyone more deserving of this year's Ag Ambassador Award. Thank you and great job.
Brad, congratulations. You are well deserving of the 2014 Governor's Ag Ambassador Award. Your professional life, you have dedicated yourself to educating others. Today is a day where we say thank you for your service, and we expect more great things out of you in the years to come. Keep up the great work.
I apologize for not being able to be with you today, but it's a great privilege to have you represent our industry as well as all of agriculture in this role. And you look at those that have gone before you, it's a very elite group, and you're well deserving to fit into that group, and we want to congratulate you on your award.
Brad, on behalf of South Dakota State University and all of agriculture, congratulations on being named the fourth winner of the Governor's Ag Ambassador Award. And I just want to express personally how proud I am of you, but also how grateful I am for your leadership in South Dakota and agriculture in our state and across the nation. Well done.
Brad, my friend, congratulations. Well deserved. Thank you for being the 2014 South Dakota Governor's Ag Ambassador. Keep up the great work. Thank you.
Brad, congratulations. We know that you couldn't have done it without Peggy. I don't know how you married a woman 10 or 20 years younger, but somehow you managed. But please accept this gift as a token of our appreciation and our gratitude and our admiration for your great service to South Dakota and South Dakota agriculture. And then...
Well, thank you. I don't know where you start. First off, thank you to the governor, excuse me, and Secretary Lynch and his staff for putting this together. When I got the first letter, I thought, you know what, I really appreciate that, the nomination, and I thought that's as far as it was going to go. And then when I get a call from Jamie Crew with the department and the letter from the governor that I had been chosen, and I thought back and I thought, you know, I love doing what I'm doing. When I wake up, I love being part of the farm and not afraid to tell people about that. And by all means, thank you to Glenn Muller and the South Dakota pork producer. Stacy Sorlane is here. And I think back and just a little story, and I know we're on a time, but how it all started. And, you know, 30 years ago when I actually got a scholarship from the Pork Council. And I always say that was probably the most expensive scholarship. I got $200 and then they put me on the council 30 years ago and I've been doing stuff since. But at the same time, it's the most expensive, but it's the one that I've appreciated the most because it got me involved and through the South Dakota pork and we raise cattle and it's all of agriculture. And kind of what got going out and done, I've done a number of speaking things and where it all started is, and I'm sure everybody in this room, and I'm honored to be up here, but I know everybody that's part of this today has done something great for agriculture, and you all need to be commended on that. But it got started, and we read letters to the editor and how they were denigrating what we were doing on our farm. Peggy and I, what are we going to do about this? We got to write to it. We can't let that go on. And about that time is when the Pork Board come out with an Operation Main Street, where they train speakers to go out and visit with civic groups. And since that, I've done probably 150 groups. I think I've hit most of them in South Dakota, and I'd love every one of them. I don't care if there's 8 people there or 125 or 150 I spoke to. And that fellow that wrote to the editor, he happened to be in one group when I was speaking in Mitchell. And he sat there in the audience, and I went through my presentation, and I show pictures, and I talk about, and we ask questions. That's the best part. We just got to explain what we do. And Ken was his name. When I got all done, I said, Ken, I says, I know you wrote a lot of letters to the editor about being kind of negative against CAFOs and cattle feedlots and hog barns. And I said, I hope I've answered your question. And he said, Brad, you have. And since that time, and literally that's been probably 12 years ago, and he's never wrote a letter to the editor. And my point is, you just have to talk to people. You guys are the best at what you do, and that's all I do every day. If I go out and I get a chance to speak with somebody, I don't care if it's in New York City or Mount Vernon, South Dakota, take that opportunity and let them know what you do. And don't forget your neighbors. We had an open house when we put our barn up 7 years ago. We had 400 people come and gone through our finishing barn, and Peggy sent out the personal invites to every one of the neighbors. We've changed a lot, not only in pork industry, but all of agriculture, of how we farm, and they don't necessarily know what we're doing anymore. And so make sure you don't forget your neighbors and explain what you're doing on your farm, because it goes a long ways. The final people I want to thank, and I'm glad that Peggy's up here, and first off, I got some family here, my mom and dad. They're still actively on the farm. I knew I was saving this to last for a reason, because it was going to get kind of tough. And I appreciate what them, we're working side by side every day, and you can't get any better than that. My son Brent is here. I have a daughter that's actually, she's over in Madison, Wisconsin, finishing her first year of residency, and she's a doctor, and she'll be coming back to South Dakota. She's got 2 years left and got a 6-month, our first grandchild. And so I thank them because they've been all the times that they probably know how to cook pork sandwiches better than anybody in the state because they got drunk along with us when we were cooking. And Brent's actually, he's a test engineer right now in Jackson, and so working on farm equipment. So how better a farm kid out still doing that, and so I appreciate that. I've got my employee Thomas Smith and his wife Megan here, and why I'm out doing this stuff that I so enjoy, and it's an opportunity for me. It really is. Somebody's got to be taking care of the home front, and I'm so glad that you asked Peggy to come up here, and she's the last one I want to talk about. When we've been married just about 31 years, and she's been beside me, and when I'm gone, she's taking care of the home front along with Thomas and the kids when we were young, and that makes it all possible. So I look at it as an opportunity that I've had, and I appreciate it, and I so appreciate this award today. So thank you.